Hey guys, my name is Patrick Cogen, and in this video, I'm going to share with you how to overcome fear and anxiety, so stay tuned. If you are new to this channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it so you can grow your online business and take it to the next level. When I was younger, I used to live in a fear. And I used to have a lot of anxiety. When I was in high school, I couldn't ask pretty girls the most simple question, what time is it? I was afraid of what will she think of me, and I told myself all these unrealistic stories that never happened anyway. I used to be shy and I played video games, and mostly I was spending my time by myself at home, so I could be safe. But after I finished high school, I knew I wanted more from life. So I started to change. I had a vision and I set different goals. I started taking action towards them and working on myself since then. And I've been able to overcome that fear. I believe that fear is natural. That fear is something that will always be there, and it is a good thing. Without fear, you wouldn't probably be here. It keeps us alive and safe. However, sometimes fear is stopping us from doing certain things. And you need to learn how to overcome that fear. There is a great book from Susan Jeffers called Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway. And the concept of the book is exactly like the title. You need to feel the fear first, but you have to do it anyway. Did you know that fear stands for false evidence appearing real? You can't let the fear hold you back from pursuing your dreams. I will share with you guys few things you can do so the fear won't hold you back anymore and you can start taking action towards your goals. First, you need to realize that fear is an emotion. Fear is an emotional state that we experience. It's basically the same state like anger, frustration, or even confidence or happiness. Before you can experience the fear or any emotional state, you do certain things in your body and in your mind that put you in that state. A lot of people believe that they have certain emotions because of external sources. If it's raining, they feel sad and depressed, and they don't realize that they do certain things to feel that way, to experience that particular emotion in their bodies. But you need to realize that every emotion you experience, whether it's depression, anger, or even fear, you have 100% control over. You can't control the outside world, but you can control your emotions and emotional state all the time. You can decide how you use your body language and your focus. These things can change the way you feel. If you are feeling depressed or scared, do you use some kind of body language to express that emotional state? Yes, you do. You are probably more closed off in your body, your head is down, your shoulders are down, and also your voice is more quiet. Do you recognize some of that? Imagine you want to do something, whether it's some kind of business, public speaking, or even approaching your dream girl, and you are afraid to do it. Start being aware of your body language. How are you using your body in that moment? Are you feeling confident in that moment, meaning your body is straight, your voice is loud, and you are 100% ready to do it? Probably not. You feel the other way around. These are all things that affect how you feel. This may sound simple, but how we use our body language affects how we feel. You've maybe heard that emotion is created by motion. And this is 100% true. If you are scared, you have tension in your body, your shoulders are down, and you have shallow breathing. This physiology affects how you feel. This is your body posture, and your focus can create even more fear. If you are experiencing fear, you focus on certain things that are making you feel that way. When I was younger and I tried to ask pretty girl for the time, not only I changed my body posture and started feeling fear, but also my focus changed. Suddenly, I had many thoughts like, what if she doesn't like me? What if she rejects me? Or what if she knows that I think she is pretty? And the more I focus on them, the more fear I felt. Because if you focus on failures and worst case scenarios, you will create even more fear within yourself, and then of course, you are not able to follow through. When you focus on things, you are creating different images in your mind. They have different colors, shapes and sizes, and they amplify your emotions. Does that make sense? Your body posture and your focus are going to determine how you feel. So what are you focused on to feel that fear? You have to start being aware of that, whether it's your focus or body language. When you feel certain emotion, start observing that. Watch how your body posture changes and where your focus goes. When you understand that fear is a state and you have 100% control of that, you can change it. This requires practice, but with time you will be able to determine this and do certain changes in your body posture and focus to overcome the fear. I want to thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys do want to check out more videos like this, I will put links in the description below, so go ahead and check them out. If you guys enjoyed this video, like it, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on the future content. If you have any questions, just go and comment below and I'll help you out. Thanks for watching.